We will take the advance that Tina is here from Georgia, and we talk about some terracotta. I'm talking here about terracotta, and Carolina is talking there about wine tourism. We go there, one moment, and you came back. Olá.
Olá.
Olá, tudo bem?
Estamos aqui
a assajar.
A fazer a visita no nosso dia de portas abertas, ok? Porque hoje é dia de portas abertas aqui no Soalheiro. E estamos então aqui a explicar esta parte da...
Desculpem, eu vou traduzir porque a Carolina fala um pouco portunhol. Embora seja da nossa equipa, fala um pouco portunhol. Vou traduzir em português. Hoje é o dia das portas abertas. Vocês são um grupo, com certeza, que viu a divulgação de Portas Abertas. E vamos ter muita gente hoje, não é? Quantas pessoas?
Não sabemos ainda.
Não sabemos ainda, tudo surpresa.
É tudo surpresa.
É tudo surpresa.
Temos aqui pessoas também da Galiza.
Certo. Temos pessoas da Galiza.
Wine Lovers.
Wine Lovers. Eu só estou a traduzir porque eu é que tenho o microfone, ok? Porque nós percebemos o que a Carolina diz. Mas como eu tenho um microfone... Paulo, isto vai ser um vídeo fã, sabes, daqueles galegos, não é?
Exatamente. Então, Luís, como tens o microfone, pode-nos explicar aqui a parte do terramate, a terceira parte do terramate.
Ok. Há uma expressão espanhola que eu não vou dizer relacionada com ovos, huevos, e aqui temos o nosso terramate. Se nós olharmos para a terracota, que nós vamos falar a seguir, nós vamos engatar este vídeo terracota e cimento, ou seja, barro e cimento. Aqui temos uma cuba em forma de ovo. Qual é o segredo desta cuba? Aqui o vinho nunca está parado. Ele está sempre em movimento. E como está sempre em movimento, a borra que está no fundo, que são sedimentos, que dá volume ao vinho, vai estar sempre a levantar. Então vamos ter, no fundo, um vinho com um bocadinho mais de estrutura. Isto é um dos vinhos diferentes que nós temos no Soalheiro, chama-se Terra Mater, e nesse Terra Mater também tem um pouco de lote de uma outra especialidade que vamos aproveitar, uma georgiana, para falar sobre essa técnica de fazer vinho em recipientes de barro. Ok, faça boa visita, não vos vou incomodar mais. E como vós também sois de Galícia, não? Galícia?
Do Ribeiro.
Do Ribeiro? Muita competência. No Ribeiro não é competência. Vós tendes muita mais qualidade.
Não existe.
Não, não. Conhecemos... eu conheço bem os vinos. E, bueno, estão evoluindo muito. No passado tinha muita quantidade, volume. Hoje em dia tenéis pequenos produtores que também fazem calilha top. Tem que visitar o Ribeiro também. É aqui ao lado de Espanha, poucos quilómetros. Mas para visitar o Ribeiro, não se esqueçam de passar no Soalheiro também. Ok? Até já. Then we will link this wine tourism about the Terra Mater, because we have the dimension of concrete eggs and the dimension of terracotta that get in the wine, and we link and we talk about this with Tina, that is our stagiaire from Georgia this year.
Yes.
How we say good morning in Georgian?
Tilam shvitopisa.
Hey, it's very easy Georgian, eh? And how we say?
Gamar Joba is generally hello.
Hello.
Yeah.
Then Gamar Joba. I visited Georgia not long time ago,
yeah.
And Gamar Joba is one of the things people say more.
Yeah.
And also one thing that is very particular in the meal in Georgia is to toast, is to fazer uma saúde. Which is the name of this?
Kaumar juice.
Give me more juice is the translation. Give me more juice. You understand?
Sure.
When we stop, and we stop in the meal 5 times minimum, we have the tamada, which is the tamada, it's the guy that make the speech. And after the speech, we have give me more juice.
Give me more juice.
Okay.
Or no more juice.
Oh, no more juice is a it's a group we have, the group that went to Georgia. We told so many times that in the end we say no more juice, please. But this is another private joke. Then, talking serious, Tina. Georgia is, for us in the world of wine, the first country that begin making this style of fermentation.
Yeah.
Can you speak a little bit about this?
Yes, sure. So
I can take your own bottle for you.
Thank you. So we started producing wines like 8,000 years ago in Georgia. But the main difference from this and Georgian traditional winemaking is that we bury them in the ground, which ensures the constant temperature throughout the year, which is very particular for, we call this vessel Query. It's basically the same shape, but it has more like,
Yes, I explained the angles there down. It's not so flat.
Yeah.
It's like a grape, in fact. And it's more like a egg
Like egg, but upside down. Yeah.
And it's true, like Tina, it's true. It's, of course, it's true. But like Tina says, usually the cuvée, the cuvée, it's put, cuvée, it's put it on the...
In the soil.
In the soil. And because this maintains the...
The constant temperature.
Yeah.
As for the winemaking process, we use the least possible intervention. So we're basically very lazy people. We put them together, everything, and we wait for it until it ferments. And so the wine is ready. And the special shape, I don't know what to talk about.
The special shape of the...
The query. Should I go into this kind of detail?
Yes, of course, you can go on these details. Because Tina wants to explain a little more detail. If you don't understand, no problem. You can send us a message. You can explain, for example, people usually ferment how?
So what they do is we use skin contact in Georgia. So even for white wines, we do the fermentation in the contact of the skin. And we use... leave the wine in contact with the skin, which gives the wine a special color. We don't like to call it orange color, we usually call it amber color.
Correct. I also prefer amber color.
Yeah, sounds more romantic probably.
Yeah.
And the wine has some tannins as well because it has skin contact. And it's very particular, very different from European method.
One detail. It depends on the producer, but usually, for example, you receive the grape, you crush the grapes, correct? You put inside, and then you leave the grapes until, for example, February, March, and you don't move it. This is why Tina says that they are a little lazy.
Lazy
no,
people.
They are clever, because when they keep the grapes inside, they extract a lot of tannins, and then the wine is more protected. From oxidation, it's a totally different style. Also because the oxidation happens naturally.
Yeah.
Tina brings us a wine. Can you speak a little about this? If it's a producer or something of the story or not?
Yeah. So the producer is actually from Champagne. And the reason he went to Georgia was not wine. Surprise. Because he married a Georgian woman. That's why he came. But then when he arrived in Georgia, he decided to dedicate his time to winemaking. And so what he does, it's a lot of experimentation. So here we don't have pure Query wine. We have some oak aging as well in French oak. So he has his French touch to Georgian wine, which is very, very interesting to try. The wine is not filtered, it has some sediments natural in it.
We can see
color
it.
Is really,
This is like, how we make, this is like our style in Terra Mater and Nature. How we make this link, because this culture of natural wines and LIW, low interventive wines, is very important also in Soalheiro. We have a family, the natural family. That it's Terra Mater and Nature, that it's also no filtration. Of course, we don't make a lot of skin contact. In fact, we don't make skin contact, but we want that our wine is protected by the sediments. Then which is the fantastic thing also when you receive, for example, so young people from Georgia, okay, that is try to learning about wine in Portugal, is that always we learn something. Always you learn something. And then Tina, for example, is also linked with wine tourism in the learning in this school. And this is nice because we can put together different experience, different people, and for our improving our team, our knowledge is the future. Please, if you want to know more details about wine, you must discover our full channel of Swedish. Ciao!